Hey everybody, Michael Antonovich with Swapmoto Live. We are out here at Fox Raceway for the launch of the 2020 Honda CRF250R. Joining me is Jason Abbott. A lot of big changes to the bike this year, so let's just make it quick and run through them. Abbott, give me the 411.
Yeah, so we basically made a lot of updated and refined certain key areas. But for this year, just like last year on the 450, the 250 got a new frame and swing arm. And then kind of going along with the chassis and swing arm, we have updated suspension settings internally and clickers. So, promoting more traction, better handling, all that stuff. So, something small, but we have new brake pads in the rear, a shorter brake line, and a longer brake pedal on the rear. So, just improved braking and overall performance. And also, just something super little is that we got the rear disc guard has been taken away, so for improved cooling and whatnot. But the big thing about this model is the updated engine. So for this year, for 2020, we focused on bottom and mid power delivery. So we have updated combustion chamber shape on the head. We have an updated piston to go along with that. We have a new cam profile that reduces the overlap, and then it actually leaves the valve, exhaust valve open just a little bit longer. That basically really, really helps to improve the initial response bottom to mid, along with the header pipe on the right-hand side. We got rid of the resonator, so again, improved bottom mid, and then also the internal of the mufflers have been changed, again, to promote power up on the bottom portion. Second gear has been made taller, so there is a little bit larger gap between first and second, which a lot of people are asking for, and just it helps for the power to stay in the prime spots. And then we also have updated coating on third and fourth gear, along with a stiffer clutch spring. So all those little changes basically result into a motor package that gives that initial response out of the hole that people are asking for, improved torque through the pull on the mid-range. So like I said, not groundbreaking, but everything that we did is exactly what the consumer was asking for.
Going through all the engine stuff, it's all solid. Let's talk about the chassis a little bit. Honda's always been known for a super nimble bike. This is no different now. Small refinements this year, and then to coincide with that is some suspension updates as well.
Yep. So yeah, the new frame and swing arm are actually lighter than last year, but the frame has increased yaw rigidity, where the torsional and vertical are actually the same. So yeah, and then the suspension, like I said, valving updates, some small internal updates, but overall it's more precise handling, better feel, all just to improve the overall handling.
When you're always pulling more performance out of the engine, there are other areas you guys have to address. Looked like a new air filter element and then new radiator. So just little things like that to make the bike at its best all the time.
Yeah. So with the radiator, it's a larger radiator, more cooling surface, more fluid. So trying to keep the temperature down. And then also, yes, the air filter is 10% larger surface area. So, it definitely promotes, more of a throaty feel. So yeah, those kind of things go along with each other very well.
I did notice a lack of some of the options that were on the 450, so the traction control and things like that aren't here yet. Any reason why?
No real reason why as far as the traction control and whatnot. I think that's just kind of a development process.
Always one bike first, then the next one?
Yeah, because as you see with our CRF-R lineup, the 450 is usually 1 year in front of where this 250 is. So this could be something you can see later.
So when will everybody be able to get their hands on this? I mean, today's our first day on it, but I'm sure the public is itching to get a new red ride.
Yeah, so the bikes are actually on their way to the dealerships now. They actually might even be there as we speak. So we try and time it. We try and time these intros with the media to make it to where if the consumer sees this shootout or sees the intro and sees your guys' test, they can go to the dealership and sit on the bike and actually purchase it right away. So instead of, the timing is something we always think about.
So all of these changes, obviously that's going to come at a cost. What's the MSRP for this 2020 ride?
MSRP is $79.99. You can visit Honda's website at powersports.honda.com for more information, or visit Swapmoto Live, and check it out.